I'm going to show you how to make a perfect jeans hem. So you're going to need just your standard foot. We're going to cheat a little bit and use our blind hem foot, foot D. I'll show you that. And you also need your multi-purpose tool to really see how this is all going to work when you have a really thick seam to go over. So I've got some colorful thread here. So first thing we're going to do is go ahead and create the seam. Go ahead and do right sides together and 5/8 of an inch, and that's 15 millimeters. So you can just go ahead and sew a regular seam. We're going to show you how to get up and over this really thick area here. All right. Let me go ahead and tell it that I'm working on woven heavy fabric, so that way it makes the stitch length a little bit longer for the areas I'm picking here. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and press it open. I'm also going to leave this seam over to this side, and we're going to detour for just a second. Are you ready for a little trick? So you have a foot called a blind hem foot, and we're going to use it for some top stitching and cheat just a little bit. You'll notice on your blind hem foot that one toe, the one on the left, is actually higher than the one on the right. So it is going to be the one sitting on the thicker part here. We're also going to take our straight stitch, and we're going to move our needle position to the far left. So it should go to -3.5. That's as far left as it will go. And I'm going to just, from the top side, I'm going to take the foot, and I'm going to run the seam right down the middle of these two toes. Small toes on the top side, big toes on the lower side. And we're going to get a nice, perfect, straight stitch. That's going to top stitch it down, make you look really good. And if you don't normally sew that straight, it's because you're not using some type of foot or guide. The other foot that I would normally use, remember this is a cheat foot, so it's not the one we use all the time, but there is an edge joining foot. It's a regular foot with a blade in the middle, and that blade would have sat right down here. You move your needle position, top stitching perfect every time, handles of bags, stitching in the ditch, decorative stitches, crazy cold stitches, so many things. That is the one foot that I would recommend buying. If I could only buy one foot, that's the foot that I buy. If I can only have one, I know that would be so hard. But okay, so we're going to go back to just a regular A foot and a regular seam. So I went ahead and just go push. If you push one down here, that'll take you to just a straight stitch, woven heavy still. So now we're going to go ahead and turn this once and twice. Now, of course, you would normally have this all pressed and measured and perfectly pinned, but for today, we're just going to go ahead and do this. Now, most people are going to want to stitch from this side because that's the side they can see this part from. But tell you the truth, to get a better look, you need to stitch from the top. That's why they call it top stitching. Okay, so we're just going to go ahead and set this underneath. I can use one of the lines here to keep my fabric straight and nice and even though I can't see it from underneath. Now, here's where everybody gets hung up, and so does the machine. We're going to stop with the needle in the down position. I'm going to sew a little bit more until the machine kind of almost can't stitch up that hill. Honestly, I could probably push it and it would do just fine, but we have this great little tool, the multi-purpose tool. Notice on one side it's a little thinner than the other side. So with this, I'm kind of in between here. I'm going to lift, my needle is in the down position. I'm going to lift up the presser foot. I'm going to do the thin side. We're not that thick. Some jeans are going to be thick. Now, as soon as I start, when I come down and I lower, when I start to stitch, The tool is supporting the foot back here, so everything is level. So instead of the foot trying to go up the mountain, now the foot is level. And as a presser foot, it can press evenly on the toes and on the back and go across now the thicker part, kind of the plateau of the big thick seam, and all the stitches are the exact same length. Now, before you go flying off the other end of this, take the tool, spin it around. We're going to stitch into the middle of this far enough. Stop, because your machine will stitch through this, and then come on down. Let's take a look at how perfect that seam actually is. Without me having to push, pull, break a needle, skip stitches, look at how perfect those stitches are over that really thick seam there. So this is definitely something to try out, and try out that little top stitching trick, but head over to your Husqvarna Viking dealer and ask for the edge joining foot. It is my most favorite foot.